The warm environment, though outside the hall, you may face some real warm and hot weather, but bear with us, everything will be all right. So in the next 5 days, we'll have a very interesting and technical discussions of the ISO 307 technical committee. For the benefit of some of the press people who are here present in the hall, the ISO started, Indian Standards, International Standards Organization, started its activities on the blockchain, because blockchain is one of the technologies becoming very, very important in the world. In fact, people started describing blockchain because the blockchain, there are various technology formats, and nobody knows which format is the right format. The industry, government, everybody was getting confused. At this point of time, International Standards Organization, the chaired by Craig, he started this activity in 2016, Craig? 2016, the activity started by ISO, TC307. Then parallelly, Indian government, Bureau of Indian Standards also started our activities working along with ISO in the year 2017. We have about 50 people drawn from industry, academia, R&D, government. They're all working in close association with ISO TC307. And our members also participated in most of the plenary sessions. This is the sixth in the series. I attended the London plenary session. The other important thing for the Indian press, there are more than 47 countries, 43 countries are the participating as a voting members in this TC307. So whenever any technical discussion happens in the plenary session, these country representatives, they have the voting right, and they participate in the seeing whether they are accepting the particular discussion for a vote. Based on that, it will go to the next phase. So there are also many observing countries who do not have the voting rights. They are also participating. The reason is they also wanted to have a similar kind of standards in the respective countries. That's the reason why we welcome a lot of countries who do not have the voting right, but they are participating in the TC307 discussions. So apart from that, we invited some special guests, because it's happening in Hyderabad in India, so that they will have the exposure to what's all happening to the global standards for the blockchain technologies and distributed ledger technologies. In fact, when I was there in Spain recently, participating in the European Commission convergence on the blockchain congress, so I told the members, today the blockchain is very fragmented, a lot of platforms are there, very confusing for the industry. It's like in India we keep describing like four blind people trying to describe what the elephant is looking like. So today blockchain is like that. Many people, they are getting confused, and some implementation, unfortunately, without properly knowing, they were not able to implement properly. So in this scenario, what ISO and also the BIS is doing a phenomenal job trying to find out how to really crack the interoperability issues, scaling issues, reliability issues. All these things are being discussed in these committees. Hopefully, Craig will tell more about where the standards at this point of time is happening, when the standards will be out to the industry. Hopefully, maybe within 12 months or 18 months, Craig will talk about those things. So hopefully, once the standards are out, the mass adoption will happen, because the acceptance of the global standards by the industry, by the government, will enable the lot of global players also start delivering those different products following the global standards. That also brings down the cost of the operations also lower, and also there will be harmony and the uniformity also will take care. So it's a very important thing which is happening, because blockchain, people say it's like internet. Whatever internet has done to the world, the blockchain technologies, people say that it is going to do the same thing in various verticals, whether it's healthcare or agriculture or land registration or education. There's so many segments the blockchain is likely to impact those segments. As far as the India is concerned, India is still in a nascent stage of implementing blockchain technology at this point of time. I want to really thank Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, who is the Principal Secretary IT and also the industries from state of the Telangana. This one progressive state, we have really taken the blockchain technology to the highest level in India. They created a new district called Blockchain District. And the reason for creating the blockchain district is creating the ecosystem, whether it is the skilled manpower requirement for the blockchain technologies, with the R&D is required for the, that's why they involved the institutions like IIIT, IIT, and ISBs. These kind of institutions are also involved in the blockchain districts apart from the industry and the government. And today, this is the only state where the production stage blockchain implementations happened in the government. And I think we should appreciate the leadership of Mr. Jayesh Ranjan, who has really taken this technology to the heights of implementing and taking it to the production level. In fact, if you see the scenario in India, more than 92% of the blockchain implementation, they are still in the proof of concept stage or pilot stage. Only 8% are into the actual production. And majority of it is coming from the BFSI segment, where the trade finance is one vertical where they have really implemented blockchain by the all the banks and other institutions. And the governments like Telangana government have already implemented in some of the education and other land registration related segments. More about these things, I'll request Sri Jayesh Ranjan to talk about these things. And before I close, I want to really thank Craig Dunn, the chairman of ISO, for really accepting our request to bring this sixth plenary session to Hyderabad. Thank you so much, Craig. And I want to thank all of you for traveling from various countries coming to Hyderabad. And this location is in the top of Hyderabad. Hyderabad is full of mountains. So this is a mountain called Jubilee Hills. This is all hills, and you are on the top of Jubilee Hills. From here, you can actually, whenever you get some time, you can just look around, you can see the entire city of Hyderabad. There are three cities here, Hyderabad, Secunderabad, and a new city called Cyberabad. Cyberabad is full of IT companies. All the Fortune 500 IT companies, the R&D institutions are located in Cyberabad. You can see all three cities from this mountain. That's one of the reasons why we wanted to have this conference. Instead of getting this conference into some five-star hotels, we thought, I mean, you can come here. This is a kind of a educational and R&D institution set up by the government of Telangana, and it's a nice place. But there are some difficulties when the government organizes this kind of event in the government buildings. You may not get a five-star or seven-star facilities, but definitely our hospitality team will take care of all the issues. If there are any issues to this thing, please bring it to our notice so that we will be able to resolve those issues, because we are all going to be here the next 5 days in all the working group discussions and all that. And I hope your stay will be very comfortable here. With this, I once again want to thank Craig as well as Mr. Jayesh Ranjan for making this happen. And also I want to thank all of you to come here and participate in this very important plenary discussion for the IS4 TC307 discussions. Thank you once again. I also want to thank all the media people to come and cover this event. Thank you.
A very good morning to all of you, respected dignitaries on the dais, Shri Jayesh Ranjan ji, Principal Secretary ID Government of Telangana, Mr. Craig Dunn, ISO TC307 Chair, Mr. Jay Chaudhary, Mrs. Rama Devi, and ladies and gentlemen. So it gives me immense pleasure to welcome all of you to this amazing city of Hyderabad to have these ISO TC307 meetings on behalf of BIS. And BIS is thankful to ISO TC307 for providing the opportunity to host this meeting in India. And Bureau of Indian Standards, as many of you may be knowing, is the national standards body of India, and has been leading standardization activity in India in various sectors. And the Bureau of Indian Standards has so far produced more than 20,000 Indian standards in various sectors, including IT. And I am heading the IT standardization wing at BIS, and there are more than 350 technical committees. Out of this, about 29 committees taking care of IT standardization. So we have a dedicated committee on blockchain taking care of blockchain standardization at national level, and this committee is being chaired by Sri Chaudhary ji, who is present here amongst us. And I think the interaction with him, like the various delegates, and will be very useful during the course of the meeting. And this committee is the national mirror of ISO TC307, and all the IT committees of BIS acts as various national mirror committee of various ISO IC committees. And we are actively participating in the area of emerging technologies like IoT, artificial intelligence, smart cities, smart manufacturing. And it is the endeavor of BIS and India to host more and more meeting in India to give the opportunity to the stakeholders to interact with the international community and to participate at high level in the international standardization activity. So last few years we have hosted, like in the last 2 years only, we have hosted SC41 on IoT. And then JTC1, when it was WG9, now merged with JTC1 SC42, Artificial Intelligence on Big Data. And then we hosted SC7 on Software and System Engineering in India in just last 1 year. And before that, we also hosted JTC1 SC27 on Security and Privacy. So it is our aim to host more and more meetings in India. And last to last week, JTC1 was held in New Delhi. And I think many of you attended that meeting. I could see many familiar faces who have traveled from Delhi to Hyderabad to attend this meeting. And now, we have appointed a large pool of experts from the BIS committees to these international committees. And I'm sure during this 5-day event, Indian experts on the blockchain who would be present here will have discussions with the, since the Indian community is here, so they will have better opportunity to participate effectively. Telangana for supporting and organizing this important event in Hyderabad. BIS is really thankful to Mr. Jayesh Ranjan. Actually, they are the key people who supported, and they are responsible for having this event being happening. Sincere hope that this week-long meeting would be a great success, and we would be able to benefit.
Well, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning, and it's my great pleasure as chair of TC307 to welcome everyone to this wonderful city of Hyderabad. I know we're going to have a really great meeting, and also to express our sincere thanks and gratitude for the people that have made it possible. So can I extend thanks to the state government of Telangana, also to the Bureau of Indian Standards, to the Dr. MCA HRD Institute of Telangana, where we're meeting for this week, so thank you for having us, and also to Ashish and all his team for preparing for this week's activities. This is the sixth plenary of TC307. We've met previously in Sydney, Tokyo, London, Moscow, Dublin, and now we're very pleased to be meeting in Hyderabad. Which has fast become a globally recognised centre for information technology around the world. So it's really great to be here. And can I also note the vision of the state government of Telangana to become a world leader in emerging technologies, including blockchain, and congratulate the state government on the foresight for the policies they've put in place to develop leading skills and expertise, innovation, research, and the community that you're bringing together under the blockchain district in Hyderabad, to promote the development and use of this exciting technology. It's great to see. And while it's still a developing technology, I know I don't have to convince anyone in this room today of the power of the technology to change the world for the better, and that's of course why we're all here and involved in the development of international standards. And it's things like the capacity to create truly unique digital assets and identities, the birth of the digital token economy, and of course the opportunity to establish new forms of trust that all genuinely represent fundamental innovations in the world today that can make the world a better place if appropriately used. And despite the speed at which blockchain technology is developing and emerging, and it's moved very quickly, if you like, from the edge of ecosystems where most innovations first develop into the mainstream with major corporations around the world, major technology companies around the world, including in India, investing heavily in the development of technology, it still has some challenges like every emerging technology does. And in a sense, part of the aim of our technical committee is to help the world overcome and address some of those challenges, and to do in a way that establishes and codifies internationally accepted ways of working to support improved security, privacy, scalability and interoperability of the technology, and to do so in a way that encourages the widespread adoption of blockchain technology, and to do so in a way that creates greater innovation, enhanced governance and sustainable development. And that's really the goal or intent of TC307. One of the challenges of our committee, of course, is to match the speed of the emergence and development of this technology, which is happening very quickly around us. And we need to sort of acknowledge that, but also make sure that we don't get ahead of ourselves and effectively codify standards before a consensus emerges on the best way of doing certain things. And that's a balance we're seeking and working very hard to get right. And the way we've sought to achieve that balance is by first establishing standards in what you might call the foundational standards of the technology. So we're hoping to launch standards in the next 12 months on terminology and the reference architecture. But at the same time, we're also working actively to develop technical reports on a range of relevant areas to do with the technology. And those technical reports are really trying to establish, if you like, the state of the art or the leading thinking on a shared understanding and learning of key aspects of the technology. We recently published our very first technical report, which was in the area of, or the application of smart contracts in the blockchain environment. And we're hoping to publish four more technical reports shortly. And those go to the security management of digital custodians, the security risks and vulnerabilities for blockchain, privacy and personally identifiable information protection considerations, and fourthly, we hope to develop a technical report on relevant use cases. So whilst we've made good progress, there's a lot of work ahead of us, and it's going to be another very busy week for all the people involved and for the 50 countries that are participating in TC307 in one way or other, and of course a number of very important liaison groups. So let me finish by again thanking the state government of Telangana, the Bureau of India Standards and everyone else who's made it, this meeting possible. We're all very, very excited to be in this wonderful city of Hyderabad. We're going to have a very successful meeting, I know, and we're very keen to learn about everything that India is doing in this area of blockchain and digital ledger technologies. Thank you.
Mr. J. Chaudhary, Mrs. Reena Garg, Srimati Ramadevi, members of the Technical Committee 307, ladies and gentlemen, I also welcome members of our Hyderabad Blockchain District who are also attending this inaugural session. Let me first of all welcome all of you. It is a matter of great honor for us in the government of Telangana to be hosting this very important, very milestone event. I was told earlier by Craig that while this is the sixth plenary meeting, you expect to complete your work for the time being over perhaps the next couple of sittings, and what you are going to discuss here in Hyderabad over the next 5 days will greatly advance and enhance the work that you have been doing, and it will bring you much, much closer to your objective of creating globally accepted standards. I would also like to congratulate BIS for representing our country's interests in these kind of discussions and negotiations. And I'm very sure that at the end of it, whatever outcomes of the successive plenaries are, not only India as a country, but the world as a whole will enormously benefit, and it will further advance the interests of not only enterprises, but also users. I'm again very happy to share with you that while our at the national level, the discussions and decisions about adopting blockchain and distributed ledger technologies took a while because the country was still debating about the logic and the legality of cryptocurrencies, because as we all know, the whole concept of blockchain or DLT started in association with cryptocurrencies. And it is only after lots of dithering was a final decision taken that while cryptocurrencies will not be permitted in this country, there is nothing wrong with DLTs. A large number of state governments have now started initiating some very substantial blockchain projects. And as Mr. J. Chaudhary mentioned, a large number of blockchain activities in this country today are found to be in the government realm. Enterprises have done a bit, but a majority of the blockchain activity is happening within the government. And again, I'm very proud to share with you that the government of our state of Telangana is in the forefront. In fact, if you actually list out how many blockchain applications have been started, what is the diversity of the applications, you will find us very, very prominently standing out there, both in terms of the numbers of blockchain use cases and also the range of areas in which we have applied DLT and blockchain technologies. As again Mr. Chaudhary mentioned, while BFSI sector is a very logical sector to implement blockchain, we have gone beyond the BFSI sector quite significantly, and there are more than a dozen use cases in other areas also, including land reforms, including education, including microfinance, and very recently we have in our state initiated 2-3 new initiatives. One of it is appearing to be a real path breaker, which is on P2P energy trading. We are also starting new pilots in vehicle life cycle management, tackling the issue of counterfeiting of medicines and drugs, and so on and so forth. As Craig, I was trying to explain to you, beyond the use cases also, creating a community around blockchain is a very important responsibility of the government. And again, this is something very unique in the country. Many of you will see the logo on the extreme right of this screen, and you will be wondering what is that. Blockchain District is a very unique concept which we have promoted here in Hyderabad. Incidentally, last year, about a year ago, we hosted the International Blockchain Conference here in Hyderabad. And when we saw the kind of enthusiasm, as Craig mentioned, the enthusiasm is not only among the startups, but even some of the big IT services companies, IT giants also have invested in creating blockchain practices. There are mid-scale companies, niche companies who are into blockchain, startups are there, academic institutions are there, Government of India institutions, state government. When we found so much of enthusiasm around this technology, we decided to become the first ones to create that ecosystem. And the blockchain technology today has members representing all these interest groups. So we have larger companies, mid-scale companies, startups. We have Government of India institution called CDAC, the Center for Development of Advanced Computing. And we have academic institutions like the ISB, like the IIIT. And of course, the state government is at the fulcrum of this entire blockchain district. Very recently, we have been able to add new members also to the blockchain district. Some of you would be aware, one of the largest blockchain full solution providing company called Bitfury. Bitfury has entered into an agreement with our blockchain district to promote research and innovation. A capacity building program, training program on widespread usage of blockchain amongst the professional community is also on the cards, along with Intel. Similarly, two academic institutions, IIIT and ISB, have decided to institute chairs within their respective institutions to promote greater R&D. So the point is that I'm very sure that while we are in the lead today, many other Indian states also would emulate what is happening here, and there'll be a massive proliferation of blockchain use cases. And it is in this context that having globally accepted standards are very, very important. In fact, if we look back 3 decades ago, or maybe even 4 decades ago, what happened with the software technologies is something which is very, it actually indicates the way we have to move ahead. Many years ago, and in fact till recently, many enterprises, many governments, many users used to find issues of interoperability, issues of scalability, issues of security, very, very relevant and a matter of great concern. In fact, I remember when I had joined the government and we were starting looking at software solutions, one very common phenomena that all of us would face is what was called a vendor lock-in. Like you associate your project with one vendor and there is no coming out of it and you are completely tied up and till the vendor provides an upgrade, you just can't move. But nowadays, for the past one decade or so, we don't worry about this issue at all because a very seamless kind of an interoperability solution and system and institutions have been created. And I'm very confident that once the same is attempted for blockchain, the transition from just POCs into widespread application will come very, very fast. As Mr. Chaudhary also pointed out, today the plethora of architecture, the platforms, the protocols are confusing. Of course, we know that a few of them, Ethereum in particular, is in widespread use. But we also know that new attempts are being made to create better protocols. But at the same time, for a user, it requires absolute clarity on which is the protocol and for what purpose it is best suited. Therefore, interoperability is something which is very important. Security, of course, we now see that the blockchain has been offered to the world as a solution where it tackles cases where trust is of deficit, where transparency, accountability are low. But if tomorrow questions are asked about blockchain itself in terms of its privacy, in terms of its security, then the very issues which it hopes to address will be jeopardized. So finding secure solutions of blockchain use and finding ways to prevent misuse of confidential information or private information is again something very important. And I was very happy when Craig mentioned that you are bringing out technical reports on these very subjects, and we would be very keen to read what you offer in your reports, and hopefully we'll be able to adopt it in our activities as well. So once again, I would like to let you know that the government of Telangana here is in the forefront of using blockchain. So for most of you who are working on standards, this should give you lots of confidence that the work that you are doing is considered of tremendous value. There will be huge amount of applications and use cases, at least in this state to begin with. And the contribution that you make will go a long way in furthering everyone's interest. The final thing which I would like to offer to you is that as your technical committee meetings progress, if you want to try out any idea, suppose you have discussions, and of course I'm very happy to understand your methodology that it is all consensus based and there are voting members and then there are observers and there's a free exchange of thoughts and views and eventually the best ideas get selected through a process. But at any point of time, if you feel that there is a divergence of views, people have different opinions, and if you feel that the best way to check which opinion matters or which opinion is worth pursuing is to try it out in a particular controlled and contained environment, we'll be very happy to offer that opportunity to you. So as the government of Telangana, anything that you want to try out, we are always willing to make it happen for you, because as I mentioned, the concept of blockchain district is very unique. It has large companies, it has mid-scale companies, it has startups, it has institutions, it has government of India, it has state government. So very rare that you find such a comprehensive and such a holistic kind of a platform. So once again, I wish good success to all of you. I know that these decisions, these discussions are prolonged and sometimes they may seem going nowhere, but behind all that process is definitely the optimism that you will come up with something very, very useful. So also enjoy your stay in Hyderabad. As Mr. Chaudhary said, this is the best time of the year to be in this city. The weather is beautiful. This is a very festive time. And while many other parts of the country are struggling with fog and haze and pollution and all that, this is a clean city, welcoming city. I'm sure you will enjoy your stay. And I do hope that you will give us a chance to host you in future also. Maybe your last concluding plenary, when you describe, when you finalize everything, you should again bring it back to Hyderabad.
And I think these things are happening here, as our Principal Secretary, Mr. Jayesh Ranjan Ji, has indicated earlier. You know, we came up with our own blockchain policy framework
which is first of its kind in India. We have companies right from startups, mid-sized companies, various kind of companies coming up with innovative solutions in blockchain technology. And we have a good talent pool, you know, and a very dynamic community here in blockchain. So overall, like I would say, we have a very good conducive ecosystem for the blockchain industry to flourish here in Telangana. Actually, when Mr. Jay Chaudhary, he came and met our Principal Secretary Jay Shranjan, you know, suggesting that the government host the event here, he readily agreed and allocated the resources required, you know, both the budget and the teams to organize this event. Thank you, sir, for making it happen here in Hyderabad. You all know Mr. Jay Chaudhary is the chair of the ECO 307 from India. He has actually attended a couple of several events earlier. I think the last one is in London. And he actually got that experience to us and sort of guided us, you know, to organize this event. Thank you, sir, for providing all the overall guidance. In fact, yesterday also he was here, you know, supervising and giving suggestions to the team. Thank you, sir. Bureau of Indian Standards co-host, an excellent partner, I would say, you know, was very supportive right from the beginning. And both the teams, their team is based out of Delhi and we are in Hyderabad. They actually work in a very well coordinated manner, you know, to give you a kind of a seamless experience, I would say. As Mr. Jay Chaudhary said, there could be some minor, you know, inconveniences. Kindly bear with us. But the overall experience, I assure you, will be good for you. I thank Mrs. Reena Garg and her team, especially Ashish Tiwari, who has given excellent support for us, for our teams, you know, right from the beginning to organize this event. I thank Mr. Craig Dunn for actually, you know, agreeing to host this event here in Hyderabad. And as our Principal Secretary said, we hope to see this event in the concluding session too. So I take this opportunity to once again invite all the delegates who are present here and who are participating virtually in this event from across the world. I'm sure that this TC 307 would come out with certain recommendations, reports, you know, that would actually accelerate the blockchain growth and adoption across the world. Thank you.
ఇది అంటే బ్లాక్ చైన్ చాలా ప్లాట్ఫామ్స్ ఇవన్నీ ఉన్నాయి. చాలామందికి కన్ఫ్యూజింగ్గా ఏ ప్లాట్ఫామ్ ఉపయోగించాలో, ఏ టెక్నాలజీ, ఈ కన్ఫ్యూజన్లో ఇంటర్నేషనల్ స్టాండర్డ్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్ ఒక స్టాండర్డ్స్ తీసుకురావాలని చెప్పేసి ఇది 2016లో స్టార్ట్ చేశారు. ఇది ఐఎస్ఓ ఇస్ ఏ గ్లోబల్ ఆర్గనైజేషన్. మన ఇండియాలో దీనికి ఈక్వలెంట్గా బ్యూరో ఆఫ్ ఇండియన్ స్టాండర్డ్స్, గవర్నమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఇండియా వాళ్ళు కూడా ఒక కమిటీ ఫార్మ్ చేశారు, LITD 29 అని. ఆ కమిటీకి నేను చైర్మన్. సో దీని ఉద్దేశం ఏంటంటే మనం స్టాండర్డ్స్ అని ప్రాపర్గా డిఫైన్ చేసి, ఎందుకంటే రేపొద్దున ఇంటరాపరబిలిటీ తర్వాత ఇష్యూస్ అన్నీ ఉంటాయి. అందుకని ఒకసారి వరల్డ్ స్టాండర్డ్స్, గ్లోబల్ స్టాండర్డ్స్ వచ్చేస్తే ఆ స్టాండర్డ్స్ ఉపయోగించేసి చాలామంది బ్లాక్ చైన్ ఇంప్లిమెంటేషన్ సులువు అవుతుంది. అవి డిస్కస్ చేయడానికి ఈరోజు దాదాపు 50 కంట్రీ డెలిగేట్స్, అంటే వీళ్ళంతా ఓటింగ్ రైట్స్ ఉంటాయి. వీళ్ళు కాకుండా అబ్జర్వర్ కంట్రీస్ కూడా ఒక 15 అబ్జర్వర్ కంట్రీస్ కూడా పార్టిసిపేట్ చేస్తున్నారు. దాదాపు 97 ఇంటర్నేషనల్ డెలిగేట్స్ ఆర్ పార్టిసిపేటింగ్ ఇన్ ది 5-day ఈవెంటు. ఇందులో నెక్స్ట్ 5 డేస్ ప్రతి ఆస్పెక్టు, స్మార్ట్ డాక్యుమెంట్స్ ఉందనుకోండి, స్మార్ట్ కాంట్రాక్ట్స్లో ఏమేమి ఉండాలా, ఏం స్పెసిఫికేషన్ ఉండాలా, ఏమి ఉండకూడదు, వీటి మీద చాలా డిబేట్స్ ఉంటుంది. తర్వాత అన్నీ అయిపోయిన తర్వాత అది పాస్ కావాలంటే ఓటింగ్ ఉన్న కంట్రీస్, ఇండియా కూడా ఒక ఓటు ఉంటుంది. అట్లా ఈ 50 పార్టిసిపేటింగ్ కంట్రీస్కి వాళ్ళు ఓటింగ్ ఇచ్చిన తర్వాత దెన్ ఇల్ కోటుది నెక్స్ట్ స్టేజ్. సో ఇది 6th ప్లీనరీ ఐఎస్ఓ ఈవెంటు. దీని తర్వాత నెక్స్ట్ సింగపూర్లో అట్లా మిగతా కంట్రీస్ తీసుకెళ్తారు. ఈ బ్లాక్ చైన్ అనేది ఇప్పుడు ఒక హారిజాంటల్ టెక్నాలజీ అయిపోతుంది. బ్లాక్ చైన్ వేర్ ఎవర్ ది ట్రస్ట్ ఈజ్ రిక్వైర్డ్. ఇప్పుడు డిజిటల్లో నాకు ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఉంది, ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఎవరైనా హ్యాక్ చేసి మార్చేస్తే మొత్తం అంతా గార్బేజ్ అని గార్బేజ్ అయిపోతుంది. అట్లా కాకుండా అది ఆ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ సెక్యూర్ చేయాలంటే బ్లాక్ చైన్ ఈజ్ వన్ టెక్నాలజీ. అందుకని ప్రైవసీ, సెక్యూరిటీ, తర్వాత ఐడెంటిటీ, ఈ ఇష్యూస్లో బ్లాక్ చైన్ ఈజ్ ది ఫండమెంటల్ టెక్నాలజీ. అందుకని బ్లాక్ చైన్ అంత పాపులారిటీ వస్తుంది. ఈ డిజిటల్లో మనము స్ట్రాంగ్గా డిజిటల్ అసెట్స్ని జాగ్రత్తగా పెట్టుకోవాలంటే అది బ్లాక్ చైన్ చేస్తే అవన్నీ ప్రొటెక్ట్ అవుతాయి. అందుకని బ్లాక్ చైన్ ఈజ్ బికమింగ్ వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్.
బ్లాక్ చైన్ స్టాండర్డ్స్కి సంబంధించిన ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ సదస్సు ఏర్పాటు చేయడం జరిగింది. మన అందరికీ తెలిసినట్టుగా బ్లాక్ చైన్ ఇది చాలా ఒక కొత్త టెక్నాలజీ. ఇప్పుడే గత ఒక సంవత్సరం నుంచి ఇది వాడుకోవడానికి వచ్చింది. మిగతా రాష్ట్రాల కంటే తెలంగాణ రాష్ట్రంలో ఎక్కువ వాడుకోవడం జరుగుతూ ఉంది. కానీ ఈరోజు కూడా గ్లోబల్ స్థాయిలో, ప్రపంచ స్థాయిలో వీటికి ఇంకా స్టాండర్డ్స్ ఫైనలైజ్ అవ్వలేదు. అంటే బ్లాక్ చైన్లో రకరకాలుగా టెక్నాలజీస్ ఉంటాయి. ఏ టెక్నాలజీని వాడాలి, ఏ సందర్భంలో ఏ టెక్నాలజీ వాడాలి, ఒక టెక్నాలజీ నుంచి ఇంకొక టెక్నాలజీకి షిఫ్ట్ అవుతూ ఉంటే దాన్ని ఇంటర్ఆపరేబిలిటీ అంటారు. సో ఇంటర్ఆపరేబిలిటీ ఎట్లా జరగవచ్చు, టెక్నాలజీ తయారు చేసేవాళ్ళు ఎట్లాంటి నిబంధనలు పాటించాలి, అదేవిధంగా బ్లాక్ చైన్ వాడేటప్పుడు ప్రైవసీ, సెక్యూరిటీ అవన్నీ ఎట్లా గట్టిగా స్థాపించాలి, వీటన్నిటి మీద స్టాండర్డ్స్ తయారు చేయడానికి 46 దేశాలు కలిపి ఒక కమిటీ ఏర్పాటు చేసింది. దాన్ని టెక్నికల్ కమిటీ 307 అంటారు. సో ఇప్పటికే 5 సార్లు ఈ మొత్తం ప్రపంచంలో వివిధ ప్రాంతాల్లో వాళ్ళది మీటింగ్ జరిగింది. 6వ సారి వాళ్ళు ఈరోజు హైదరాబాద్లో కలుస్తున్నారు. సో ఇట్లాంటి స్టాండర్డ్స్ రావడం మనందరికీ చాలా ముఖ్యం. ఎందుకంటే నేను ఇందాక చెప్పినట్టుగా గత ఒక సంవత్సరం నుంచి కొన్ని బ్లాక్ చైన్ టెక్నాలజీస్ వాడుకోవడంలోకి వచ్చింది. సో ఇంకా భారీ స్థాయిలో ఈ టెక్నాలజీని ఉపయోగించాల్సిందిగా ఉంటే ఈ స్టాండర్డ్స్ అవసరం ఉంటుంది. అండ్ తెలంగాణ లాంటి రాష్ట్రానికి, అంటే మాకు పూర్తిగా ఇప్పటికే బ్లాక్ చైన్ టెక్నాలజీస్ ఉపయోగం మీద, వాటి నుంచి వస్తున్న రిజల్ట్స్ మీద పూర్తిగా నమ్మకం కలిగింది. సో మేము ఇంకా పెద్ద స్థాయిలో దాన్ని, ఆ టెక్నాలజీని ఉపయోగించే పరిస్థితిలో ఉన్నాము. సో ఇట్లాంటి స్టాండర్డ్స్ తయారవ్వడం మాకు కూడా చాలా అవసరం ఉంటుంది. భారతదేశానికి అవసరం ఉంటుంది, ప్రపంచానికి అవసరం ఉంటుంది. సో ఆ దృష్టితో చూస్తే ఆ నేపథ్యంలో ఈ కమిటీ మీటింగ్ ఇక్కడ హైదరాబాద్లో జరగడం చాలా ఇది సంతృప్తికరమైన విషయం. కానీ ఇప్పుడే వాళ్ళు చెప్తా ఉన్నారు ఈ మీటింగ్తోనే తుది రిపోర్ట్ వాళ్ళు ఇవ్వకపోవచ్చు, బహుశా ఇంకా ఒకటి కానీ 2 సార్లు కానీ ఇంకా మీటింగ్ చేయాల్సిందిగా అవుతుంది. బట్ ఎంత తొందరలో వాళ్ళు స్టాండర్డ్స్ బయటికి తీసుకురాగలితే అంత మన అందరికీ ఉపయోగం ఉంటుంది. ఇక్కడ ఇది 5 డేస్ సమావేశం, 46 దేశాల నుంచి ప్రతినిధులు ఉన్నారు. వాళ్ళు చిన్న చిన్న గ్రూప్స్గా ఏర్పడి చిన్న చిన్న ప్రతి గ్రూప్లో ఒక్కొక్క టాపిక్ తీసుకొని వాళ్ళు క్షుణ్ణంగా దాన్ని డిస్కస్ చేసి కొన్ని గైడ్ లైన్స్ తయారు చేస్తారు. గవర్నమెంట్లో ఎక్కువగా, అంటే తెలంగాణలో ఇప్పుడు 6-7 డిపార్ట్మెంట్స్లో ఇది యూజ్లో ఉంది. ఉదాహరణకి మేము మొట్టమొదట ఇది ఎడ్యుకేషన్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ సర్టిఫికేట్స్ భద్రత కోసం ఈ టెక్నాలజీని ఉపయోగించాము. తర్వాత చిట్ ఫండ్స్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్కి రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ శాఖ దీన్ని ఉపయోగించింది. ల్యాండ్ రికార్డ్స్ కింద ఈ మన రెవెన్యూ శాఖ ఉపయోగిస్తూ ఉంది. దెన్ డ్రగ్ కంట్రోల్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్ అనే ఒక శాఖ ఉంది, వాళ్ళు ఈ కల్తీ మందు, కల్తీ మెడిసిన్స్ని నిరోధించడానికి ఈ టెక్నాలజీని ఉపయోగిస్తూ ఉంది. తర్వాత స్త్రీనిధి, అక్కడ గ్రామీణ అభివృద్ధి శాఖ కింద స్త్రీనిధి బ్యాంక్ ఉంది మనకు తెలంగాణలో, వాళ్ళు మైక్రో ఫైనాన్స్కి సంబంధించిన ఉపయోగిస్తూ ఉన్నారు. ట్రాన్స్పోర్ట్ శాఖ దీన్ని వెహికల్ లైఫ్ సైకిల్ మేనేజ్మెంట్ కింద ఉపయోగిస్తుంది. సో ఇట్లాంటి ఎనర్జీ శాఖ ఎనర్జీ ట్రేడింగ్ కింద ఉపయోగిస్తుంది. సో చాలా శాఖల్లో ఇది వాడుకోవడం.